Okay, so this is a video walkthrough. This chair is too low. This is a video walkthrough on how to install the GPS card in a Dell Latitude 6420 XFR. Now, this isn't the first one of these I did. This is the second. The first one I did, I effed up terribly. Well, I didn't really mess it up. I just had no idea what I was doing and took out way too many screws. Luckily, what I'm finding is the GPS. The GPS has two parts. I'm making a random guess here, but three if you include the cable. But you got the card, cable, and the transmitter, receiver. I don't really know, whatever. That doohickey. The thing that I found on the last one, pretty certain is going to be the same on all the ones that I'm working on, is this part here, the receiver, is already installed here. No, I don't need to put this part in. Last one, I didn't know where it was. I took apart the whole screen unit, took the thing off, wires, pain in the arse. So I'm just gonna double check to make sure that it's in this one too. And once I've done that, I'm going to just ignore that little piece. So you don't need to take the whole screen off. These guys have these little panels up here. These actually come off separate from the rest of the screen bezel or plastics or whatever the hell it's called. I'm trying to sound all professional. But anyways, I'm just gonna take this out. This getting infringement. I will say this is a lot easier to go on a screen that wasn't attached to the rest of the computer, but totally not worth all the running the antenna cables back. That was an annoying pain. Yeah, there's another video I made. It's probably going to be about three times as long and involves quite a bit more cussing. That would be the first one I did. Metal on these screws. The hell it is, but it's really easy to strip up the screw head to the point where you can't take them out anymore. So, best to be careful about that. Okay. Oh, and I'm using my handy dandy little magnetic screw cup. The thing's nice because not only does it hold the screws there, but it magnetizes them so that when I'm putting them back in, I can just stick them on the end of the screwdriver. That's really easy. That comes off, and ta-da! Yeah, see, it's already in there. So that's cool. So, put that part back on. And frankly, I'm not even going to bother checking out the rest of these. Most of our laptops that we've had in the past, I have no issue working on them, though I've never had any formal training on working on a laptop. They sure as hell let me break the crap out of a bunch of them when I first started working here, and then I kind of taught myself. And, I mean, really, the only differences between working on a laptop and a desktop is a heck of a lot more screws, a heck of a lot more delicate, tiny parts that are easy to break, and more things that are integrated with the motherboard, so if you break them, you kind of got to replace your whole motherboard. So it's basically the same thing as working on the desktop. It's just far more risky. I'm not going to take the keyboard out, but one thing that a lot of people screw up on, I find when they work on laptops, I have myself, and my little brother did recently, and a couple other people I know. When taking the keyboard out of a laptop, there's a ribbon that holds it in. Usually it has a small plastic clip. It won't really seem like it's a clip, but it'll seem like it's just holding there. You can just yank on the ribbon, it'll come out. Not true, it's actually a clip. And if you just yank on the ribbon, you'll probably break that little plastic clip, and then you'll be using masking tape or Scotch tape to hold your keyboard ribbon in, because you don't want to spend the money to buy a new motherboard just for a plastic clip. professional video. Keep the cussing to a minimum. Okay. Last but not the one. So, receiver's in there, so that's not an issue. So next part, before I do this part, take the battery out. We need to get to where this card goes, which is right there. Now, this model, since it's super beat a bear to death with it, ultra indestructible, that means a heck of a lot of screws. Alright, so basically, all these screws on here come out. Luckily, I found they're all the same type of screw, so there's... I count them afterwards. That helps me see if I miss it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 15, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, and the one that doesn't come out. Excellent. That's all you should really have to take out. On these ones at least, they are kind of glued down, so you might notice a little resistance when you just popped it off. That's normal. Try not to do what I did and bend it like that because you're torquing this screw. You want to do that kind of when it was straight lift. Got lucky. Anyways, so there's that. Now, on the last one of these I did, I disassembled all this crap, undid all these wires, tons of extra. None of that's necessary. Since the receiver is already in the screen, and even if it wasn't, the gun was, so I was just trying to figure out where the damn wires went. You don't need to mess with any of that. You can just careful with these connections. I don't know what they're called. I can just tell you that they're really delicate and easy to bend up. And then you got to sit there and unbend things with paper clips and stuff. And it's pain in the rear. Put that tape down, hold it on there. Lovely. That's that. The only other thing you gotta do is do the power cable. Power cable. The other shirt and bolt ends are basically identical. Yeah, doesn't really matter which one you plug into where. This one is going to go into this side. Be careful not to bend things. Little tiny pins, these bend. Your hard time bend. And then just trace it down this way. These guides don't work very well. Mm-hmm. No, you're supposed to stay in there. Okay, time to get some high tech. Bam! Like a professional. Ta-da! Back on there. Things are good. Nothing's in good. Nothing's on there. The sticky's not really sticking, but doesn't matter. I don't care. Doodad goes a lack of that. Crack-a-lackin'. Excellent day. Done! And that is how you put the GPS card in these. Exciting.